Now I'm going to start the diseases of the neuromuscular junction. Before the discussion of the diseases, I'm going to discuss the physiology, normal physiology of the neuromuscular junction. One should know this is the presynaptic neuron or the motor neuron, which is going to polarize the motor end plate or the postsynaptic membrane. The space between the presynaptic membrane and the postsynaptic membrane is known as a synaptic cleft. When there is an action potential, when the action potential comes in the presynaptic membrane, it leads to the depolarization of the presynaptic terminal. This is the terminal. Depolarization of the presynaptic terminal and the depolarization of this presynaptic terminal leads to the opening of the calcium channels. When there is an opening of the calcium channels, there is an influx of the calcium from synaptic cleft into the presynaptic membrane. And this calcium inside the presynaptic membrane is going to bind with the vesicles of the neurotransmitter, which result in the release of the neurotransmitter into the synaptic cleft. And this neurotransmitters can be inhibitory or excitatory. We will discuss later which neurotransmitters are inhibitory and which ones are excitatory. Inhibitory which lead to the hyperpolarization, and excitatory which will lead to the depolarization of the postsynaptic membrane. And this neurotransmitter is going to bind with the postsynaptic membrane or the motor end plate, which lead to the ion changes in the membrane and the formation of the action potential or inhibition of the action potential depending upon the type of the neurotransmitter. Now come to the synthesis of the acetylcholine in the presynaptic membrane. The acetylcholine is formed by the acetyl coenzyme A and with the combination of the choline with the help of enzyme choline acyltransferase. And this acetylcholine is going to store in the synaptic vesicle, and the synaptic vesicle containing the ATP, ACH and the proteoglycan. When there is a possible action potential or the threshold which lead to the influx of the calcium inside the membrane, and this calcium will bind to this vesicle and it lead to the release of the neurotransmitter into the synaptic cleft. This acetylcholine will going to bind with acetylcholine receptor, or we can see it, acetylcholine receptor is also called nicotinic receptor, or the sodium potassium ligand gated channels, which leads to the influx of these sodium and the potassium channel will lead to the depolarization in the postsynaptic membrane. The action potential in the motor end plate is known as end plate potential, and the one synaptic vesicle, or we can say the one quantum or the one packet of energy, will produce the action potential in the postsynaptic membrane. And that action potential which is produced in the postsynaptic membrane is known as the miniature or the small possible action end plate potential. And these miniature or the small possible end plate potential going to summit and form the full-fledged end plate potential, which leads to the local depolarization of the adjacent muscle fibers. Then when there is no need of acetylcholine will going to degrade it into the acetyl CoA and the choline with the help of enzyme choline esterase, and this choline is going back, it will go back to the presynaptic membrane via the sodium choline co-transporter. And will be again using in the formation of the acetylcholine. And the neostigmine is a drug which is going to inhibit this choline esterase, and this sodium choline co-transporter can be inhibited by the drug known as hamicholinium. Now come to the synaptic transmission. There's type of arrangement of the synapses. There is the one-to-one synapses and the many-to-one synapses. What is mean by the one-to-one synapses? The neuromuscular junction from the neuromuscular junction is the example of the one-to-one synapse. Action potential is the presynaptic membrane, motor neuron, which lead to the action potential in the postsynaptic membrane or the muscle. This is known as the one-to-one synapses. And the many-to-one, the single presynaptic cell will produce the action potential, and in many postsynaptic cell, for example, when there is a spinal nerve, it will produce this, only the single spinal nerve will produce action potential in many muscle fibers. This is known as the many-to-one or one-to-one. If I talk about the input of the presynaptic membrane, there is excitatory or inhibitory. Excitatory postsynaptic potential which lead to the depolarization of the motor end plate, and toward the threshold there is opening of the sodium potassium channels, and the neurotransmitter which neurotransmitters are the excitatory: acetylcholine, norepinephrine, epinephrine, dopamine, glutamate and the serotonin. These neurotransmitters are excitatory neurotransmitter. And if I talk about the inhibitory postsynaptic potentials will lead to the hyperpolarization of the membrane away from the threshold. It is due to the opening of the chloride channels, and the neurotransmitter which are inhibitory neurotransmitters are the glycine and the GABA. If I talk about the summations, what is mean by the summation? Sum of the action potentials and the postsynaptic membrane is known as the summation. If I talk about the special summation means when the two excitatory impulses or the action potential occur simultaneously at the same time. This is known as the special. And if I talk about the temporal, two excitatory action potential occur but overlapping each other. If I talk about the facilitation, augmentation or the post-tetanic potential, mean there is a tetanic potential of the presynaptic membrane, and due to this tetanic stimulation of the presynaptic membrane will lead to the greater frequency of the action potential in the postsynaptic membrane more than the expectations. And if I talk about the long-term potentials, long-term potentiation means the memory formation of the memory due to the new protein synthesis.